Where are you going?
Home. I've got to get some kit.
What for? I didn't think you had to sign on till Friday.
Don't joke, mate.
What are you doing this afternoon?
Nothing much.
Well, keep there, then.
I'll come round if you like. Didn't know this was your paper route.
I've been ringing you.
Why?
Well, you need the work.
I told you, I'm not interested in favours.
How's the job hunt going? Put an ad in the police review yet?
I'm not interested in domestics. I'm not interested in missing persons.
So where's your work going to come from? Your friend was only born yesterday. Nobody's going to put you on solid straight away. Look, even I don't turn down missing persons. The contact's in there. I said I'd send someone round this morning.
Yeah, okay.
You better swallow a tube of toothpaste before you go.
Don't know what you've been drinking, but I think it was for external use only.
Hello? Do you want to put your car on the forecourt? It's a bit dodgy around here.
No, I'll be
right. Later, Lacey. 10 o'clock.
This is my brother.
Hi. Michael Lacey, how are you? Do you want a cup of tea?
No, thanks.
Listen, you're going to have to give me a bit more detail. All I know is that you're looking for a man called Henry Brennan and he's gone missing, is that right?
Henry's got some of our money and we don't know where he is.
How much money?
Enough to make it well worth employing you.
Mm-hmm. Not enough to go to the police?
We know Henry. He's a bit of a mad bastard. Goes on the occasional bender. He's probably met some woman. That's how he is.
Right, so you think he may have just borrowed this money? You don't think he's a thief?
No. He's a good mate. I don't want him getting into any trouble. We just want you to tell us where he is.
Just locate him?
Yeah.
You're not a bounty hunter. We want you to be discreet because we don't want people to know we're looking for it.
We're in the same business as you, Tony. Henry works for us. Our clients might begin to feel a bit drafty if they thought they'd been dealing with a crook.
Understood. Anybody asks, I'll say I'm from the Child Support Agency.
Brennan hasn't been seen for a week. They won't say how much he's had it away with, but it's a fair amount.
Enough to leave the country.
Well, as long as it's not your easier.
Right. First thing we do is speak to the neighbours.
Well, we want to get in the flat first, don't we?
Yeah, we don't want a forced entry.
Yeah, well, no, I know our luck. We'll find him dead in his bed, and we'll be back on the dole this afternoon.
For Christ's sake, Harry, you're not in the job now.
Definitely wasn't going anywhere warm. He's left all his summer gear here. Obviously the shy type.
What are we going to do about the door?
Well, he works for a security firm, Dunny. Let them sort it out.
Yeah, who owns this place?
Housing Trust. It's got a demand.
Oh. No need for him to come back then, is there?
There's nothing of any value in here, you know.
Looks like you packed in a hurry. Unless someone else has been here.
No toothbrush, no razor.
This is about.
Angry girlfriend?
It was posted 2 days ago. I can't make out where. Oh, shit.
Well, it's only the police.
Yeah, this is only breaking and entering.
Yeah, but they never catch anyone for that, do they? There, did we?
Oh, well, save ourselves a bit of aggro. So we're in a few favours. Brennan may have formed. Do you know any friendly colladers?
I'd rather stick to kicking doors down, Guff. Got anything to give them here?
There's the body in the skip. The AMIP inquiry.
You think that's Brennan?
Could be. It's a local investigation. AMIP's your old firm. You should have a bit of a reunion, put Brennan up as a possible runner for the torso victim. That way it looked like you doing them a favour.
Yeah, they'd love that, wouldn't they? I'll put a Stetson on, look like a real cowboy. You bloody do it.
Gary, the boss wants a photograph of the axe found in the skip. Take it in situ, yeah?
Sure, okay. What's that for, Sarge?
For his memoirs, probably. The torso is definitely a collector's item.
Mo, do you know where Nigel is?
I don't know, Gov. Sorry.
See if you can find him for me.
I was just on my way out.
Lunch appointment?
I'm briefing a Citibank on money laundering.
I've just had the detective superintendent in charge of that torso murder onto me, about it being a professional job.
Wouldn't that be more to do with local intelligence than us?
I'm doing him a favour. He wanted to know if this type of killing was fashionable with any particular organised group.
Oh. I've always thought cutting limbs off a very she-she way of trying to conceal the identity of a body.
Like a mansion compared to your other place.
We haven't got no furniture to fit it.
I'm going to have some of mine. I only use the front room and the kitchen. I don't know. Sorry, I'm late.
Well, we just started without you.
Have you eaten?
No, I brought some of the plumber's mate. Oh, that's good. Bit of tar's up before I start plumbing. You want some?
No, I'll get you a glass.
Thought you'd gone in the piss again with Tony.
Nah. Here. You don't know anything about that torso murder, do you?
In Oxley's Wood?
Yeah, that one.
No.
It's in all the papers, you know. You know what they say. The police aren't famous for their intelligence.
You get you another one, Keith.
I should be home.
Look, I've got a missing person, and from what I've heard, this man and your bloke who's been topped and tailed could be one and the same.
What's his name?
Well, I thought we might be able to do each other a favour. I'll give Emmett what I've got, and if I'm wrong, you tell me what you've got about this man.
It's not how I work, Tony.
Well, you can pull information.
Give me his name.
Henry Brennan.
Where'd you get that?
You think it might be a possum?
I know something about Henry. I doubt it, mate.
Well, how'd you know?
I'm not playing.
Oh, come on, what you got?
Looks like we'll have to find ourselves a new pub to drink in, lads.
That'll please the landlord, Barry.
What do you call a superintendent when he is no longer a superintendent?
You can call him anything you like.
An arsehole.
Yeah, you could call him that, couldn't you?
Leave it out, lads.
You gonna buy us a drink then, Tony?
Yeah, all right, what do you want?
Go. I think I'll have a malt. You better check that note, love. It's probably bent.
Yeah, well, if you're looking for fakes, you want a whole barrier up against the light.
You think I'm a fake, do you?
Oh, I know it, mate. And I nearly proved it, didn't I?
Yeah, well, there's not much point in a bent copper trying to do my legs, is there?
Don't upset him, Barry. He could shoot you.
Yeah, do you remember that copper? The one that shot a man and got off without a trial?
The one where he died?
Yeah, that's the one. What was his name, Tony? I mean, you'd know his name because you were in complaints. I bet there were a lot of complaints, weren't there, Tony?
No, there wasn't a case to answer.
So why'd you resign?
Stress. You murder someone, there's a lot of stress involved. I'll see you.
Watch out, boys. He's gonna get his gun.
Oi, Clark.
Clark, you're gonna shoot me?
Do you want us to turn around, Tony? No, you only shoot people in the back, don't you?
You're not drinking and driving, are you?
We haven't finished yet. You haven't told us whose arse you had to climb up to get off.
Oi! Leave him! Leave him! Come on, it's over! Right!
I'll have you, Mitchell.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
Make a complaint!
Jesus.
You don't look much better.
Who did it?
Barry Mitchell.
Well, the one we did for perjury?
Yeah. Just because he's got a bloody warrant card, he thinks he can do what he likes.
Well, he can, can't he? I should forget it if I was you.
You should see Miles' new place. It's knockout.
Yeah, be good to see her.
Listen, I wasn't trying to tell you what to do yesterday.
Oh, no, no, mate. It's me. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. I'll sort it out for you. I'll get the info, Cuff.
OK, I'll tell you. They reckon the torso was burnt because the man had tattoos.
Where?
I can't see.
Well, I got more than that from Amip.
So I see. You should do something about that.
Yeah.
But were there tattoos on the torso?
I've already said, Harry, I'm not telling you what's classified information, only what's public knowledge.
But Amip have no idea who the torso is. It might be Brennan. All we want is information on Brennan's whereabouts. Can't you run a check for us?
And join you on the door?
You've been listening to Harry. Private sector's a growth industry.
Yeah, so is unemployment.
I'm telling you, now's the time to get in. Clients are hungry.
And we know the only thing that has to be good about them is their credit rating.
Look, Harry is having a great time working for me. With me.
I thought he was working for us. He's supposed to be doing our plumbing.
As a favour.
Well, you know, Gov, I like a bit of moonlighting.
That's nice.
It makes sure he gets a meal. I'm glad you've got him some real work.
Excuse me. I've ordered the bill. I haven't paid my credit card. You got any cash?
Oh, that's all right, Gov. I'll get this. How much is it, Emmett?
The starters were nearly a tenner. I've got some.
Yeah?
Right,
go.
Cheers.
Mo was right to keep stum, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Anyway, I found out the torso's a grass.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, that's a thinking, anyway. A bullet they took out of his back matched the ones they dug out of the guards at the big Heathrow job, you know, the security depot. Mm. But that's all Emmett's got.
No wonder they weren't bragging.
Yeah. Nothing on Brennan.
Cheers, mate.
remember when Mo was happy with the cabana.
Thank you. And we'll need two taxis.
There's one on Saturday.
Ah, well, we'll take that one.
Could be quite a wait for the next one. Maybe you and her husband will like to wait by the bar.
Oh, we're together. Oh.
Thank you. We've paid, we're getting a taxi, and we've ordered you one.
This was meant to be on us.
Mo?
Well, next time.
Yeah, next time we take you for a Big Mac.
Bye-bye.
Cheers.
Brennan ain't the type can disappear.
He's a mashy bastard.
What do you mean by that?
Liked his women. But from what I heard, he used to exaggerate his merits. He had an elephant's face tattooed on his privates. You know, with a trunk that could squirt water.
What, you mean all fingers in no trunk?
You spoke to his ex?
Didn't know he had one.
Brennan had an ex. Linda Watson lives on the estate. The boy says if we want to contact Brennan, we need a Ouija board.
She's certain he's dead?
Oh, yeah. Just not certain where his arms and legs are, that's all.
Fitz, Brennan was running around with these people and working for security. He must have been well bent.
You think the Laces are onto him?
Nah, they'd have got shot of him. Brennan's probably been stitching them up for years, giving out security info to every firm in South London.
And now the police have got him and he's grassing on everyone. Well, don't you think Amick should know about this?
I don't listen.
What if I take it to them?
Look, our job isn't to solve their murder, it's to find Brennan.
What if he's dead?
I want something more concrete before we go back to Amick. I'm going to drop Mitchell so deep Jacques Cousteau won't find him.
Out to lunch today, Maureen?
Only if you're taking me, Gov.
Rang your mate, Gov. He thinks the torso murder's a contract killing. Thinks it may involve bikers or Hell's Angels.
They're getting a bit more organised if that's linked in with that Heathrow job.
How is the murder connected with bikers?
Victim's hip's been shattered at some stage. Had to be rebuilt. It's consistent with a motorcycle accident.
It's not only angels fall off motorbikes.
Yeah, sounds like Amber knackered.
Surely they must have something else to go on.
Yeah, I don't know why Gov put in contact with me.
Do you want some help?
Cheers, Gov, but I basically told Amit we can only provide intelligence on target organised groups. So if barbecued torsos start sweeping the country, then come back to us.
You want Henry? I'll find him for you. How much is it worth?
You know where he is, then?
50 quid.
We don't have much cash.
Please, if I help you, for the boy.
It's Henry's son.
Hang on a second, love. Please.
I got 30, that's all.
Come here, love. They want to know about Henry.
We're not going to hurt you.
Let him go!
Where's Henry?
I'm not telling you.
You're going to get one.
Let him talk. When did you last see him?
Not saying nothing.
Tell them, Darryl.
A few weeks ago.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Did you see him this last week?
No.
You spoke to him?
No.
That's a lie. He rang here yesterday.
No.
You certain?
He rang in the morning twice. I answered and he put the phone down.
And he knows him.
Who rang later then that you spoke to?
Me.
You're going to get it, Darryl.
I said leave him.
There you go, Darryl. I'm telling you.
You touch him, you won't be able to see him for bloody social workers.
I said I don't know what.
God, Darryl, we need the money. Please.
Why don't you just show him that?
You just let him go. Shouldn't have let that happen.
I feel like a bloody pimp. It's funny, because you sound like a custody sergeant.
We've got to follow some rules.
It makes a big difference to our investigation if Brennan's still alive.
Oh, well, let's have the boy beaten up.
I didn't say that.
She's a bloody drug freak. She don't stop dreaming when the alarm goes off.
You believe the boy, then?
I don't know.
It's bloody amateur. I mean, we've been given the nudge that the body's Brennan. We ought to be sending the forensic boys into Brennan's flat.
Yeah, always hoping that they don't come up with your fingerprints. Breaking in wasn't clever, Harry.
Well, it was missing persons. I thought it was under Fimble. Didn't know it was going to work out as murder.
I don't understand why Amit won't pick this up.
Well, Gov's not speaking to the right people.
Well, couldn't you tell them?
He's not in a mood for doing any favours. He wants it all boxed and gift-wrapped so he can prove he's a better copper than they are.
So instead you're going to let this kid get knocked around?
It's not that cheap.
Sounds it, Harry.
Well, it's not.
This job you've given me is crap.
You haven't got a result, I take it. That's how much I've spent so far. For that much, I could have hired a real policeman.
We've tried. I got my head kicked in by AMIP.
There are other people.
Yeah, well, we've tried Mo.
Leave her out of it. You'll need her for bigger jobs.
This is getting bigger. We need to do a surveillance.
Why?
Brennan has a son. It's only a maybe, but he may have called him yesterday. They could be in contact.
That's all you've got.
It's a shitty job.
It's not that you're making a shit job of it.
What they've told me is important knowledge of a murder. They've been policemen. They should be helping the police.
Well, they are. They've given you the information. Pass it on.
I can't do that.
Well, why not? You're ideally placed to find out who it should go to.
We look at trends, not individual cases. And Tony's already spoken to AMIP. So if I pitch up out of nowhere touting the same information, what's that going to look like?
Well, you could have heard it from somewhere else, couldn't you?
Yeah, where?
A snout.
A snout? We don't use those at ENSIS. See, if the information is good, then that's fine. But if it's a crock of shit, they're going to look at me and Tony and wonder what's going on under the table.
There must be some way you can check it.
It's not as easy as that.
Could I tell them?
No, they'd run your name through the computer and trace you back to me. I can't just sit on valuable information. I've got to be able to do something.
Yes, sir, can I help you?
I'm in to see Doug.
Yeah, sure. That'll be £4.80, please, sir.
Hello, Dougie.
How's it going, Harry?
Not bad, pal. I wouldn't trust the telephone I bought from here.
No, I'm cleaning it. You know some bastard bugged it?
The bastard wouldn't do a job for me, would he?
It's a bit of work. It cost enough.
Well, my mate says it's going on sale any day now. As soon as they've tested it. £5.40.
Well, at least there's something decent to watch.
Out of town. Works.
Don't know if it's him now, do we?
Have they got a break in the torso inquiry yet?
I haven't heard. Hoping I got rid of him.
Recycling. Jeez.
Hello?
You right at all?
Somebody's come looking for you, Dad.
Who?
Come, Mum's here.
I'll ring you back.
Same number.
Harry and Tony are dealing with bloody killers. This guy they're looking for, he's working for us. He's been kept in a safe house. He's got information that could convict Harry and Tony's clients, the Laceys, of that big robbery at Heathrow. You know, the one where the guard was murdered. Harry and Tony are leading the Laceys right to him.
But that's good you found out. You can let them know.
But then I would be passing on police information.
No, tell your governor.
He's going to want to know why I accessed the file.
Well, warn whoever's in charge of the operation.
They're going to ask questions too, like, how come I know this guy's being kept in a safe house?
We'll warn them without letting them know who you are.
I don't know who's in charge.
Find out.
Yeah. All this makes me feel like I'm still working for my old firm.
But you're not. That's not why you're doing it.
No. No.
Hi. This is my colleague, Harry Naylor.
Hello.
David Lacey.
Michael
Lacey.
How do you do?
All right.
Do you mind if I smile?
Go ahead. What have you got? We know where Brennan is. There's a few things you may not know about, Henry.
Oh, yeah?
He hangs around with the faces on the Old Kent Road. He's probably been selling security plans, and he's got himself into some kind of trouble.
Oh, Christ. Go on.
We think he's in a village just outside Newbury, Walton. Mean anything to you?
No.
Well, he's made a couple of phone calls from a pub out there.
So what do you want us to do?
Find him. Make contact, then ring us.
Thought you'd taken the afternoon off, Gov.
No.
They got back to me on that torso investigation. Got the victim's name. Seems the doctors had to insert a metal pin in his hip when it was rebuilt. And the AMIP team had it sent back to the German manufacturers, got an ID.
Was he a baker?
No, he's an informer. They're looking at people he had information on. Don't know how they think I can help.
Inspector Simon Eaton, please. Well, somebody in his team. No, I don't want to give my name. I want to give some information. It's urgent. Hello?
It concerns Henry Brennan. No, I can't say who I am. There are some people looking for Brennan. They've been hired by Michael Lacey and his brother. They're going to try to get to Brennan. Warn the inspector.
Sorry, I'm unable to take your call. Please leave a message after the tone. Thank you.
Tony, if you're there, pick up the phone. Okay. This bloke you're after? Leave him. Don't touch him. Just ring me.
Are we finished there, Simon?
Yeah. Yeah, we got enough now. Supposed to meet a friend of ours here a couple of hours ago. Got caught in traffic. He didn't leave a message for us.
Yeah. He's called Henry Brennan.
Henry Brennan.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't ring a bell.
Should have his address. He must live around here somewhere. You haven't got a phone book, have you?
Well, he won't be in a phone book, son. He's only just moved up here. He's a tall bloke, dresses kind of, well, you know, loud. I'm sure he'll have made an impression.
Londoner?
Yeah.
Do you know?
Yeah, I think I know the one.
Don't know where he lives, do you, mate?
There's some white cottages down the end of the road. I think I've seen him coming out of the end one.
Thanks.
I'll get her back.
Harry, this might not be the right place.
Yeah, but the back door was open.
Think this is it.
I thought I heard something.
Oh, please!
Hey, Roger! Come on!
Get down! Get down!
Get down!
Get down!
Get down!
Is there anyone with you?
We're ex-police officers.
Answer the bloody question!
No!
Police.
Clark, I'm arresting you for attempting to pervert the course of justice. You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so.
An ex-job.
Then you'll know you're in shit, then.
See you, wankers. Give the laces my regards.
That's what it was.
Well done. We got the others.
What others?
Up you come. Don't mind if we do your governor first, do you?
We had to locate him, that's it.
What, so somebody could bump him off?
No, I was a copper, for Christ's sake. You think I'd get involved in a plot to kill someone?
Well, wouldn't be the first time, would it, Tony? You approached police officers to give you information. Yes or no?
No.
We have evidence you spoke to members of AMIP.
I suggested the torso might be Brennan, that's all.
Who else did you speak to?
No one.
Inspector Maureen Connell. And what was her response?
Why would I want to talk to Mo?
How did you locate Brennan?
No comment.
Oh, come on, Harry. You're not doing yourself any favours. Look, we know how you lot get your work done. I don't give a toss myself, but your girlfriend's left her fingerprints on the PNC.
You can forget that.
Tell us about Inspector Connell. It must be very handy, her being a dentist.
You're barking up the wrong tree, pal.
She logged onto Brennan's file.
I'm telling you, we didn't get anything from Mal.
Yeah. Well, I can't believe she screwed her career for nothing.
Morning, Gov.
Maureen.
So?
I think we need to talk.
Those are mine.
I want to do this informally first. CIB are on their way over.
I don't know what this is about, Gov.
Your ID number was used to access a file belonging to a Henry Brennan. Would you like to tell me why?
Someone tipped me off that Brennan was the torso victim. I didn't do anything wrong.
Who tipped you off?
A contact.
Come on, Maureen. I'm trying to help you.
All I did was check to see if the information could be correct.
It wasn't your job. You accessed Brennan's file without authorization.
You asked me about the torso, sir. You were doing the superintendent in charge a favor.
Don't try to implicate me in this.
I'm not.
Clark was using you.
What has Tony Clark got to do with this?
Come on, Mo. The Yard have been on to him since he approached AMIP.
What do you mean?
I mean that they didn't need an anonymous call from you to move Brennan. They knew Clark was looking for him. They've been watching him.
You set us up.
Don't barge into my office like a pair of school kids. If you want to talk, make an appointment. Or we'll go for a drink sometime.
Mo's under investigation.
I told you, leave her out of this.
We did.
You must have compromised her somehow.
When we have to give evidence against the Laces, we're going to drop your name right in it. You knew what the Laces wanted.
I make certain never to know more than is good for me, and I advise you to adopt the same policy.
You nearly had us finger a target for professional villains.
We were bloody lucky not to get charged.
There's no comebacks on this. This was your job, your firm, your responsibility, remember? How you carry out your investigations has nothing to do with me.
I thought you'd have at least vetted your clients.
You thought all you had to do to start your own business was hand out business cards. Well, now you've learned something.
Did Clark or Naylor pay you to access the PNC for them?
I've never received any money from Tony Clark, Harry Naylor, or any other person or persons for information from the PNC or elsewhere.
So you did it as a favour?
I've never accessed the PNC as a favour to anyone. I have never passed on information from the PNC or elsewhere to anyone.
How did Clark find out where Brennan was being kept?
I don't know.
You must have a short memory. Did you ever speak to Clark about Brennan?
No.
I am showing Inspector Connell a cassette taken from Tony Clark's answer phone. Would you like to explain the message you left on his machine yesterday afternoon?
Tony, if you're there, pick up the phone. Okay, this bloke you're after. Leave him. Don't touch him. Just ring me.
It was about a decorator. Tony and I have both recently moved.
Do you really expect me to believe that?
What you're implying doesn't make sense. If I had told Clark what was in Brennan's file, why would I suddenly ring him?
Well, a lot of your actions don't make sense, Inspector. You didn't get authorization before entering Brennan's file on either occasion. And you make an anonymous telephone call to this office instead of simply speaking to a senior officer. Entering the PNC without authority is not only a disciplinary offence, it's a criminal offence under the Data Protection Act.
It would be a criminal offence if I passed on information. I did not.
Is she back?
Kate.
She doesn't want you to come in. Sorry.
Is she all right?
Well, she's been suspended. We've got to wait for a discipline board.
I'm sorry.
Look, I think it's best if you don't make contact with her. They've gone.
Thanks.
We've got to let Eaton know it was a phone tap.
He's going to want proof, and it's an offence.
Well, I don't care what it bloody takes. Mo's not going down for this.
This is going to have to be good. Look, it was nothing to do with Connell. Brennan called his kid from a pub. We got the info from a phone tap.
Would you like to repeat that for the record, Tony?
I'm telling you, what difference is it going to make on tape?
You're wasting my time.
What have you got on the Laces?
You think you're going to start screwing me for information?
Well, you got more signed, sealed and delivered?
Why?
Brennan's a grass. He's hardly a credible witness.
Get to the point.
I get the Laces to talk on tape. Connor walks.
What you do in your spare time is your own business. I'm not doing any deals with you.
How do I know you're not taping this conversation? Look, just tell me what you need to know. That they were involved in the Heathrow job? You used to be a superintendent, Tony. What's happened to you?
I don't need a lecture, just tell me what you need!
And I don't want to be picking up bits of you and Oxley's wood.
That they were involved in the torso?
What, Terry Harks, you mean?
Who?
Terry Harks, he was a torso victim. All right, I'll give you the ladybird version.
Brennan implicates the Lacys in the airport job. In exchange, he wants immunity from a little duel, as he did. The information looks good. We try and check it out. We talk to a mate of his, Terry Harks. Next thing, Terry turns up charcoaled. Brennan doesn't like the look of that, and he comes running to us. And now, because of you, those two gorillas got a bit too close to him at the safe house the other day, and he's withdrawn his statement.
So if I get the Lacys on tape...
If you get the Lacys on tape, we might have something to talk about.
Didn't expect to see you two again.
Yeah, it was a cock-up, but I thought we could sort matters out.
How do you mean?
Is it okay to talk here?
Depends what we're talking about.
We found out where they're keeping Brennan now.
Yeah? Yeah. We could finish the job properly for you this time. How do you mean?
Look, we know what this is about. You want Brennan cut up like Terry Harks. We want 10 grand for the hit.
This all sounds very interesting, but we never buy from door-to-door salesmen.
Well, we were just...
I know what you were doing, and I've never heard of Terry Harks.
Listen, we could keep Brennan out of witness box for you.
Henry knows this is an old family business. It's built on loyalty and trust. We look after our own. A bit like the Met, wouldn't you say?
Kate would kill me if Chenier was here. What do you want?
Well, we just wanted to say we're sorry.
Yeah. That makes me feel a whole lot better.
You'll be all right at the board, Mo. All you got to say is...
What would I want your advice for? Look where it's got you. If I hadn't listened to you in the first place, I wouldn't be in this position. So don't you come to me pretending that you know all the angles, right?
We tell them you didn't give us anything.
But they don't see it quite like that, and I can see why.
Mo, the governor went to see Eaton, you know? He tried to do a deal.
I don't want that. Will you just keep out of this?
Well, it hasn't happened. We had to go get the Lacys on tape.
Are you crazy?
It was to give us someone to help you. The whole reason Eaton's pissed off is because he hasn't got a result. He's trying to put that down to you.
But the Lacys won't play. There's got to be something else. What does your governor say?
Goodbye, basically. There's no way they're going to have me back at Ensis.
Well, you could give them something operational. You could get your hands dirty again.
Well... Don't come asking for any favours. I better get back.
Let us know how it goes, huh?
Yeah, yeah. I never spoke to Mr. Clark. I overheard a conversation in a pub. Someone mentioned Brennan in connection with the torso. Amip had approached Ensis for help, so while working on the PNC, I decided to check this. I realise now I should have sought authorization.
The board's finding is that you're guilty as charged. In view of these circumstances, however, the board recommends that no criminal charges be brought. But I hereby inform you of your dismissal from the Metropolitan Police. Have you anything further to say?
If I broke the rules, sir, it was for no other reason than to help a murder investigation and to protect a police witness. I am a police officer. That is what I am meant to do. My only motivation in accessing Brennan's file was to aid this investigation. Amip had very little information to go on and had already sought the unofficial help of Ensis. I did not know that Brennan was under police protection until I accessed his file, at which point I immediately passed on my information to Amip. Your rules actually prevented me from handling this situation in any other way. But you are so busy cooking up your new corporate hologram that you can't see that. You're not concerned about corruption, your only interest is image. But I will tell you, the public couldn't give a shit about the image of the police. They want law and order. No wonder the country has lost confidence in us. We don't even trust ourselves.